from LA Late News headquarters in Santa Monica, this is Mornings LA Late.
It's a big morning of Mornings LA with incredible great news about your fourth stimulus check update of 2022. The toast is toasted, the butter is buttering, and the cough is brewing. We'll go over the latest details about why your toast may be toasting a little bit more expensive. We'll be looking at the big surprises as the President of the United States announces $80,000 in new stimulus checks overnight. Wow, it's coming up late in this video. How you get those $80,000 or more checks? Stay tuned. You need it because prices of gasoline and wheat go up overnight. I'll have the latest on that. Plus, we'll start first with the Build Back Better Act. The President of the United States name checked it during the State of the Union address. All those checks are going out. $50,000 to $60,000 of checks, including adult checks, children's checks, and more. I'll have the latest on that. CRF stimulus right around that as well. The addition of a $2,000 stimulus check at bay with an inherent deadline just a few days away. What's happening? I have the latest on Mornings. Then we go to SS300. The opportunity to raise your benefits up $300 more per month. Well, Jay Powell, your head of the Federal Reserve, spoke about what interest rates are going to see in the next few days. I have the latest on Mornings. Then we turn to the big exciting details of third stimulus paying viewers big sums of money. But we need that money because guess what? Wheat prices are out of control. And where is wheat right now because of Vladimir Putin's acts of aggression? What's happening with gasoline because of the gasoline shortage and the acts of aggressions on the Black Sea? I have the latest on this morning broadcast. Then we'll be turning back to your money at home and how the refugee crisis is unfolding overseas. As Poland now sees two corridors that were set up in certain Ukrainian cities blocked by Russian officials just at the time of this broadcast. What's happening and why is the humanitarian crisis getting worse by the minute? Of the latest details overseas and domestically, your money and all your money. With the option of new $80,000 stimulus checks, we got a big broadcast. Because the toast is toasting, the butter is buttering. We have huge details about big money released overnight by the White House and more money coming thereafter. It's a big day and it's more. Good morning, everybody. Hope you're having a beautiful day and hope your weekend is going well. It is a beautiful day here along the coast of Santa Monica, California, where you're watching me live from the beautiful shores of Santa Monica, California. But we'll also be looking at the situation unfolding that's not good overseas as two humanitarian corridors in one major Ukrainian city have been blocked after a deal to let women and children flee safely has now gotten very hostile. All the latest bad breaking news minutes from now, later in this recording. First, we're going to start with those $80,000 of stimulus the President of the United States released. And boy, is it huge. More checks on top of Build Back Better, more checks than CR for stimulus. And this is the money you need in view of the rising gas prices, all the latest on what gas and wheat is doing as well. Because the toast is toasting, the butter is buttering, the cough is brewing on this big live broadcast from Santa Monica, California of Mornings. The Build Back Better Act, mentioned by the President of the United States during that State of the Union address, will get passed, and we'll have $15,000 of checks with three add-ons and three clusters. Tonight, on Evenings LA, our one-hour special broadcast at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, we'll go over all these incredible clusters of checks and all these $80,000 of new checks. Don't miss that show. It's the most-watched financial news show in prime time. It's Evenings LA, and it airs again tonight at 5 o'clock Pacific Standard Time, 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, 7 o'clock Central. In that first cluster of checks for the Build Back Better Act is hazard pay. Earn income tax credit one more year. Established in the third stimulus but broadened under fourth stimulus. $4,000 of elder care. $550 check for the college students. And then the home repairs. The incredible money for the purchase of a new electric vehicle. And the children's check, $3,600. $4,000 of elder care got in there as well. That is the first of three add-ons of checks. First of three clusters of checks in the Build Back Better Act, but there are also three add-on of checks. The first add-on of checks comes from Southern California, hear from Maxine Waters. She got the incredible provision in there, which is a little bit less than $25,000 for the purchase of your first home. Wow. Learn about more about that shack tonight on Evenings at Light at 5 o'clock. Home repairs and paid leave got in there as well. Paid leave is a lot of money, folks. This is upwards of $4,000 to $6,000 a year if you have to stay home from work due to sickness or illness. And it's huge. W-2 or 1099, and you qualify for it. And if the family member is part of the household and they have to take off from work for you, they get the check as well. There's the second add-on of checks that got in there as well, and it's a big winner for the American people. $250 billion of free home health care for seniors and people on disabilities. Then we turn to the third cluster checks. It gets even better. Seniors and free internet. Need that free internet now? It's available under third stimulus. And reach out to the volunteers featured in the commercial break. But also in that third cluster, we have also the farmers' checks, independent contractors' checks, and also the checks for the seniors. Two checks on the House, which are Medicaid gap fix and hearing. Two checks on the Senate. Dental and vision, and lowering the eligibility age of Medicare, which is par for the course when we're talking about adding checks as incredible recon, because the other checks that the Senate is vowed to add in there, of course, are MSC. MSC is a body of legislation checks that would add checks already to the recon that has about $15,000 to $60,000 of checks. This would grow it even more. Who gets it, and how does it work? The MSC is a monthly IRS stimulus check sent out from IRS on top of the $40,000 to $60,000 of checks you're already going to get from Build Back Better Act. And the eligibility is the same as a third stimulus check. Single individual, $75,000 less, you get it. Married couple, $150,000 less, you get it, double it. And a family of four, you get as well, quadruple it. It is not income. It's not taxable. It's offered on a nationwide basis, and it's not a income element. It's not California stimulus. We get a surfboard in California set. And how much you get paid? $2,000 the first month, $1,000 thereafter for up to 6 months, says the legislators or viewers of this channel. That is MSC, and that is another add-on to go into the Build Back Better Act. Now, the opportunity to get a check sooner than that is, of course, CR for stimulus. CR for stimulus has $1.5 trillion of discretionary funding in there, and that CR is just a few days away. What is a CR? What is CR for stimulus? And what's the history of it on this channel? Let's go over the details starting right now. CR for stimulus is the concept of putting a stimulus check into a continuing resolution. What is a continuing resolution? It's a budget bill to fund the federal government. Bipartisan support, small and quick. In 2020, I came up with the idea. In 2020, we got a first stimulus check, used it. Heard about a second stimulus check from months of negotiations. No deal. So I said, we can't do this. We need to get a check into something smaller. And I found it, a continuing resolution, December 2020 at the time. Put a check in there, sent it out. Well, I advocated for it. I created the concept. Inserting a check into the December 2020 stimulus, CR for stimulus, and the viewership of this channel, you, the Purple Power, advocated for it. I made history, you made history, because the CR for stimulus paid out. It became law. Millions of Americans got a $600 stimulus check because of my channel and this recording. And you as the Purple Power got it out the door. Second stimulus never happened. So 5 weeks ago, we brought on back on this channel because we're looking at Build Back Better Act and we don't have it done and we need a check. CR for stimulus, what's the update on it today? $1.5 trillion of discretionary funding, approved. Bipartisan support, done. House and Senate, done. Republicans and Democrats, done. So everything is lined up perfectly. And the discretionary funds are at the discretion of the White House and Joe Biden. This week, Joe Biden tried to take a little bit of the money for COVID testing. Don't worry, because it's still enough to get a $2,000 stimulus check in there as well. And this is happening in the CR and will be happening because it has to be passed in view of the acts of aggression by Vladimir Putin. So the good news is that you need to advocate because that CR is right around the corner. I'll have more about tonight on the Evenings LA 1 hour special broadcast at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 8 o'clock. You don't want to miss that primetime financial show. Now let's go into CR for Stimulus 2 and 3.0, still happening. And then what's happening with SS300? Jay Powell, the head of the Federal Reserve, testified this week that he's bringing down inflation, but not that quickly. Good. Because this is where your SS300 benefits. It would be tied to inflation. But what about $80,000 of new stimulus checks? Yes. Out of nowhere, while we often thought that CR for stimulus would be the first thing that could pay you a check, even before SS300, even before Build Back Better Act. Friday, out of nowhere, a $80,000 stimulus check program was announced by the White House, and I was on top of it. And as the viewership of this channel, you are ready to pounce. If you remember this channel, it was included in the newsletter, updated last night, Monday through Friday, 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. But I'm going to go over the details of how to get this money. It's brand new. And this is what we do on this channel. We pounce and get these brand new sums of money. It's before CR for stimulus. It's before SS300. It's before Build Back Better Act. And it's $80,000 of checks. How do you get these incredible sums of money? It's coming up after the commercial break. Plus the latest details of what's happening with Build Back Better, the MSC, SS300, and the latest details unfolding about wheat and gas prices. Meantime, bad news, as one humanitarian corridor out of the war-torn Ukraine is blocked by Russian officials. All the latest details of what's happening on that, it's brand new and it's minutes ago. Those details coming up in the second half of this video, and your big money, it's a big Mornings broadcast. See you back in 60 seconds as Mornings LA continues, direct from Santa Monica, California. But first, if you need assistance with any of these sums of money, reach out to the community page. Here's a little bit about the community page and what you can do to get those sums of money across the land. When looking to get second or third stimulus, if you have problems or questions, reach out to the community page. They're in the link in the description, and they'll be able to help you assist them and get that in sums of money when you have questions across any of these situations. Day in, day out, across the land, there's always a situation to ask, and they're there to help. See you back in 60 seconds.
If you want money right now, not 5 days from now, and not 5 weeks from now, then reach out to the community page. The volunteers can help you find that money for rent and utilities. That's at news.la.com/community. The community page features a series of volunteers who are viewers like you. They can help you find rent, utilities, SNAP, food benefits, mortgage assistance, and help you with eviction moratorium questions as well. Their Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram individuals reach out to them and indicate the city and state you're from, and they'll get back to you shortly. That's a community page. Volunteers working for you, viewers helping one another. Stay with LA for more. Join LLA Daily for the excitement of the new LLA live daily. The excitement starts on Mornings LLA at 9 a.m. Home LLA returns at 11 a.m. daily. And then afternoons LA Late at 1 p.m. Join us daily as the excitement continues live from Santa Monica on LA Late.
And good morning, everybody. The excitement continues direct from the shores of Santa Monica, California, live on air on Mornings LA. We'll be going back to the humanitarian crisis unfolding in Ukraine as one corridor where women and children were to flee safely is now being blocked by Russian officials in the last few minutes. Then we'll be looking at oil and gas prices and why wheat prices are surging out of control in view of the acts of aggression by Vladimir Putin. But first, we're going to go into your big sums of money, and that is that new $80,000 of stimulus checks. We got a big second half of this video in view of the world events and the economic events back at home that impact your wallet. It's a big day, and it's a big morning, and I'm excited you're here. But first, I want you part of this incredible family, so go into this video and subscribe. Like the video and consider becoming a member, and don't miss tonight's evening's LA broadcast. It's a one-hour special report at 5 o'clock Pacific Standard Time, 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. The great news is that out of nowhere, on Friday, the President of the United States announced an 80,000 new stimulus check program. And this is huge. How do you get these sums of money? I'm going to go over it in just a second. But let's pick up where we left off with CR for Stimulus 1.0 happening. Then CR for Stimulus 2 and 3.0, no inherent deadline right around the corner, to merge a House Democratic bill passed and a Republican bill in the Senate. But SS300 is the next one around the horizon. And this is the opportunity to raise your benefits up if you're on SSI, SSDI, Social Security, and Railroad benefits. The concept is very simple. Replace COLA with inflation and do it now before inflation is going down. The great news came in this week as Jay Powell, you're looking at him right now, head of the Federal Reserve, Jay Powell, was tasked with the opportunity to reduce inflation by raising interest rates. So what did he do? He had options. 5 meetings, 5 interest rate spikes, or potentially more spikes per meeting and higher spikes. So what did he do? He didn't have to tell us what he was going to do. In fact, he could have left it open. He could have left unclarity, but he didn't do that. He gave us certainty, and that was great news. He said first, I'm going to do a quarter basis point interest rate spike at the March FOMC meeting. Great. The lesser of strength of the interest rate spikes. Number two, he said that thereafter, I'm going to stay at a quarter basis point, and I'm going to go higher because I don't know what's going on with Vladimir Putin. Wow, that's incredible. Why is this good news for you? Because Joe Biden could swap out COLA with inflation right today, and you'd still be locked at that higher interest rate. Way it works is that you want to be tied to inflation at its highest rate, which is right now. 8% nationally, some states 12%. You want that higher interest rate to kick in now when we're higher. You don't want it to kick in when we're lower. Jay Powell is going to bring in a lower layer this year to about 4%, so this is huge. If Joe Biden made that phone call, your benefits will go about $200 a month per month right now, and then $100 later this year when interest rate falls to 4%. I'll feature more of this analysis tonight on that evening's one-hour special report. But guess why you also need this? A new report came in on Friday, which was the February jobs report. And the February jobs report shows you why you need this relief. The February jobs report showed that non-farm farm payroll rose 678,000 new jobs compared to 440,000 new jobs. But what does this mean? It means that millions of Americans took new jobs because they couldn't survive unemployment with inflation. When they returned back to the labor workforce, what do they see? People who took jobs in the last year saw their salaries go up 5%, but saw inflation go up 8%. Translation, people returned back to jobs in record numbers last month, but they got paid less. They got paid more than the year before, but the value of their check was less than the rate of inflation going up. That is why you need this type of relief. Now, out of nowhere, big surprise, as the President of the United States on Friday announced $80,000 in new stimulus checks. And folks, this is what you and I do better than anything on this channel. We pounce and get checks when they become live. And if you're with this channel on day one of April 2020, on the beaches of Hermosa Beach, I was telling millions of Americans, there's a program out there called EIDL. This is how you get the money, go get it. Teaching viewers how to go get the money, how to go to a website, fill out an application, and get the money. Viewers getting $10,000, $100,000, $150,000. Viewers got $25 million because of my education. At the same time, I was telling millions of Americans that a PUA program is about to go live in the country. Brand new. We had never seen it before. And that PUA program going live in some states, other states not. I show viewers how to pounce to get that money. As the Purple Hawks, you pounce and got that money. What I'm delivering to you today is an exact mirror compliment copy of what happened on day one of this channel. A new program is going live. You never seen it before. You've never seen it at issue. You didn't hear on broadcast media. It won't be on front page news. It won't be on primetime news. And it's now live. And it's a lot of money. So what is it? It's $80,000 of new stimulus checks announced by the White House. And if you remember this channel, it's now embedded in the newsletter Monday through Friday, 7 p.m. And it started last night in an updated newsletter. It details the eligibility, the amount, the links, who gets it, how do you get it, and everything you need to know. This is what this channel is bred upon. Not standing in a mailbox and opening the mailbox and looking for a check. Getting $80,000 of money by getting the fingers, going to a keyboard, or picking up the phone and making a phone call. What is it called? Here you go. The Homeowners Assistance Fund going live on Friday. But where is it live? I'll explain to you in a second. It's overseen by the U.S. Department of Treasury. Funding is at $10 billion, and it'll be run by your states on a state-by-state basis. Every state will offer it, with the exception of New York. How much do you get? Average household, $15,000 to $80,000 of checks. Now, the reason why I'm so excited about this is in addition to all the other checks covered in this video. This is not second or third or CR for stimulus or SS300. This is in addition to this. It may look like Third Stimulus. It's not. It's an addition to it. And it covers items that many viewers have asked from this channel to find that we didn't have over the last year and a half, and finally we have it. So what do you get, and how do you get it? First, this is for anyone who has a primary residence. Second, you do not have to be behind on any bill. Third, you qualify if you're a viewer of this channel. Most viewers of this channel watch this channel because they qualified for a second or third stimulus check. The eligibility for this is the same. $75,000 or less, single individual, you get it. Married couple, $150,000 or less, you get it. Family of four, same income levels, you qualify for it. Don't have to generally be behind on anything. Payout, $15,000 to $80,000 a household. And the items that it covers, absolutely incredible. It includes expenses that many viewers have asked to get coverage for in the last year and a half, and I didn't have it, like property taxes, homeowners insurance, association fees, utilities, mortgage assistance, and more. How do you get the link? What is the link? Where do you see it? It's all in the membership newsletter. Updated last night. It leads off the membership newsletter coming out 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Not a member? Go into this video, become a member. And the next membership newsletter goes out Monday through Friday, 7 p.m. Pounce and get that money. Where is the status on it? Announced on Friday, not live yet. So this is exactly like day one of this channel. Day one of this channel, I told you PUA was about to go live. It went live in three states. Texas and Florida went live 3 months later. So this is right breaking news right now. As a Purple Hawk, the concept is you pounce and get the money before anyone else. So congratulations to the viewers who have tuned in today. And you're going to be first to grab this money as soon as it goes out. Now let's go back into the details that are folding across your SS300. The SS300 is getting very good because Jay Powell said, I'm not going to come in too strong on those interest rate spikes. So I'm going to do a quarter basis point now, and that will keep us really potentially at about 7% interest inflation today, 7 or 8% next month. And that is why Joe Biden needs to make the phone call. Swap out COLA for inflation. That'll raise your benefits up about $200 more per month this month. And then when they reassess your benefits this fall, you'll get another about 4% inflation. You'll get about another $100. That's SS300. It's huge, and it's across the land. Now, when we look at the situation folding, it's important to understand that there's economic disruption. And while I can get you money, I can get you more money, and that other sums of money, it's third stimulus. Third stimulus is absolutely incredible. And what is third stimulus? It is money established under the third stimulus recon. And that money's still paying out. Have you gotten it? The average viewers of the channel has gotten $45,000. And where do you get it? Let's follow along right now. This is rent, utilities, and mortgage assistance, and viewers are getting massive sums of money this week after they got $45,000 from the before. You reach out to your city hall, your city house authority, your county hall, your county house authority. And the keywords you're going to say are rent assistance because of COVID, mortgage or utility assistance because of COVID. There are three things you must do. You must reach out to all six places. You must get multiple applications on file. And you must do multiple rounds. Now, this is where it's getting interesting, folks. When we talk about multiple rounds, people were generally doing about 3 to 5 months in a one-round endurance. But you're going to see in just a second that viewers are now getting 12 months of rent each round. My goodness. Now, what do you do to get these incredible sums of money? Open that membership newsletter. Subscribe and become a member today, and then rely on those nonprofits because the nonprofits really pay out those sums of money. And finally, get that money today because the average viewer's channel's gotten a $45,000. And this week, viewers are getting 6, 8, 12 months of rent, and some are getting 7, 10 years or a lifetime of rent. Do it right today. Don't wait across the land. The situation is falling dramatically across the land as well as two other items at issue impacted by the acts of aggression against Ukraine and then invasion by Vladimir Putin. They are oil and also wheat. Now, the situation on wheat is unfolding dramatically because guess what? You haven't heard it anywhere else except on this channel. And you haven't heard it from the White House, and you also haven't heard it from legislators. Wheat is a much more complicated subject. We're going to go right into it in just a second. But first, we're going to go over the situation unfolding about oil and gas prices. Gas prices are spiraling out of control because of Vladimir Putin's invasion of Ukraine, and the situation is not stabilized. where are we right now and what's going on with oil prices live on air if you're watching this broadcast on Mornings LA live this beautiful Saturday morning. Brent crude oil is up 7% right at the time of this broadcast. It's trending at 118 today. It has been about 110 to 120 in the last 7 days on this channel. It shot up from about $100 a barrel as soon as Putin invaded Ukraine. How does oil work? The more oil available, the cheaper the price. The less oil available, the more expensive the price. So how do you get more oil released? Well, you release it from storage. And then when you release it from storage, then you can produce more. You can only store so much oil because you only have a certain amount of storage facility. So what's at issue? The United States is not dependent upon Vladimir Putin's oil. We only import about 5% of it. What's at issue is that we have two elements at bay. First, our oil production and our partner countries' oil production. In the United States, West Texas can ramp up production of oil, but is not. While volunteering to do so, the White House has not asked them to do so. And West Texas is saying, we're ready to produce more oil, and the White House has not responded to the situation. What's happening? Very complicated. I'll feature tonight on Evenings LA. This would stabilize our U.S. economy and bring down the prices of oil if the White House worked in conjunction with West Texas. But there's new comments today that the White House is pivoting and may ramp up production in West Texas. That's for us. Our partner countries, however, are dependent upon Russian oil, and that Russian oil has now been disrupted. Countries like Italy are dependent upon oil because they don't produce it. They import it from Russia. So our partner allies have not been well versed in helping those countries. For example, United Arab Emirates, which are watching here, met during the OPEC nations meeting this week. They understood the situation. They understood countries like Italy need oil. They understood that United Arab Emirates has fortunes of oil stored and could release it to supply countries like Italy that can't get it now from Russia. What did they do? Nothing. What did the White House do about the situation? Nothing as well. Those OPEC countries have really not stepped up and helped those partner countries. I'll have more about that tonight. But what's troubling when we talk about oil, which is a big issue and certainly a topic of discussion by the White House and legislators, is that the other issue that's not being discussed is wheat. Oil can disrupt our economy and throw us into recession. And that is a risk that is now being assessed by Wall Street and also by Capitol Hill and the White House. But no one's addressing wheat. And yet viewers are in the live chat saying, I've noticed the price of bread as you've been talking about this. Why is wheat a bigger issue? Ukraine is a major exporter of wheat, and Ukrainian wheat is on the Black Sea, a very rich soil. That wheat has now been disrupted. And while the wheat may not come necessarily to the United States, it's disrupting wheat prices. Wheat prices are trending to 8 and 9 year highs, and this could cause us to go into recession faster than oil. What's at issue is that no one's really looking at the situation. Let me explain broadly why it's very troubling, and you're only hearing it on LA Light. We have risks that we need to assess when engaging in sanctions against Vladimir Putin, and those risks needed to be assessed back last year. In October last year, I told you there's 100,000 troops of Russian troops at the Ukrainian border. I told you before Halloween that Russia and Ukraine was going to be the major story of 2022. So I already assessed the risks at that point of the American people, to some extent, to which I have news information. But the White House has a lot more information than I do. And so what was the White House doing at the time to assess risks for our industries? Oil, they were tasked to look at risks to our oil industry. But wheat? Nothing. In a series of new comments, and I'm going to feature them tonight on Evenings LA, the White House was asked, have you been tasked to look at disruption of other commodities like wheat based upon the events in Ukraine, which you knew were going to happen potentially last year? They didn't look at it then. They haven't looked at it now. Congress is not looking at it either. And Wall Street has not embedded the risk of wheat, grain, and soybean prices going through the roof at 8-year highs right now at the time of this recording at all. Wheat can throw us into recession faster than gasoline prices. And wheat is more complicated. You can think about it right across the land. How is wheat more complicated? You plant the wheat seasons ahead of time, and then you harvest it, and then you ship it out. So the disruption of a wheat crop today won't just be a disruption today, it'll be a disruption for years to come. The shores of the Black Sea of Ukraine are being disrupted right now because of Vladimir Putin's acts of aggression. And that's not something that's going to be fixed in 10 seconds. What's at issue is that when we talk about oil, there may be a barge of oil that can go be rerouted from another country in 2 weeks and get to someone else. When we're talking about planting crops, this is something that gets disrupted. Far more complicated because seasons of crops are lost and then may be lost for years to come. So the pivot, not happening. The solution, not addressed. And the situation, very untroubling. I'll feature more of this tonight on that evening's Allied 1 Hour special broadcast. Now, when we go back to the situation back at hand, what do we need to know about how this impacts us at home? At home, the prices of wheat are surging out of control. Where's Brent oil and where is wheat right now? Wheat prices are surging. Now, wheat does not trade over the weekends, of course, but these were the numbers on wheat going into the weekend and certainly the prices of Brent oil. Brent oil does trade over the weekend. So Brent oil is currently at about $118 a barrel internationally, up 7% at the time of this recording, which is high. The highest we've seen on this channel the last 7 days is 120, so it's the high end. When we look at the situation for corn and soybeans, which were last trading on Friday, corn was up 19 to 29 cents, soybeans up 15 to 25%. These are 8-year highs, folks, 8-year highs. People are talking about oil at 5-year highs or 6-year highs. The wheat is at 8 and 9-year highs. Chicago wheat was up 51 to 75 cents on Friday. Minneapolis wheat was up 16 to 80 cents, and Kansas City wheat up 75 cents. This is huge. Because yes, while it may discuss a U.S. farmer, the shortage of wheat internationally pivots and impacts our economy as well. I'll have more about that tonight on that evening's Allied 1 Hour special broadcast. Meantime, what's happening with Vladimir Putin? And what is happening that is not being addressed across the board? And what needs to be done very quickly? It's very shocking and it's very horrific and it's very sad as well. You're looking at the beautiful town of Gershon along the Black Sea, desecrated by Vladimir Putin earlier this week. Gershon is just down from Odessa. Gershon is a port, is a town along the Black Sea where harvesting is very important for exports and imports. You're also looking at the beautiful town of, in addition to Gershon, Odessa has been featured on this channel throughout the last few days. Odessa is a major port city, and what Vladimir Putin's endeavor is with Odessa featured here at the Opera House is to take the port city and control all imports and exports out of the country. Again, Odessa is the major port city for the country. So he's trying to control all imports and import exports from the country. The nuclear reactor in the middle of the country has been taken by Russian forces. So now he controls 80% of all energy production in the country because that nuclear reactor is what generates energy production. But the humanitarian crisis is getting worse by the second. Let me go over the details on this. This is very hard and troubling to report on camera. But let me tell you what's going on. The only good news that came out of the Russia-Ukraine delegation negotiations this last week was an agreement to create a humanitarian corridor. What's a humanitarian corridor? Women and children who are in a town in Ukraine that want to flee to the Polish border, how do they flee? They first get the delegations from Russia and Ukraine to agree, we will allow the women and children to flee from a particular town during a couple few hours. No one will fight in that area for a few hours. How can you assimilate it to something in the United States? Imagine a major freeway in your local town or highway. You know, it's 6 lanes wide. And we're gonna shut it down, no cars, and we'll allow people in that town to flee on that highway for 5 hours, get to the next state. We will not be fighting on that freeway or highway. You'll be able to get out of your house safely and flee and head to Poland. That was the agreement. That was the agreement reached earlier this week. I feature on the channel. And at the time, Ukrainian and Russian officials said, we're not going to go into too much details of it because we don't want to make it a big news story. We just want to allow women and children, pregnant sometimes, to flee during this humanitarian corridors and get out safely. The bad news this morning is that Russia is violating those agreements. Let me give you the visual without giving you the graphic imagery. Women and children understand there's a corridor in the town. They can get out and leave their home, that they're being informed that there will be no bombing for a few hours. They can get in that corridor of a couple streets, flee to the Polish border for a few hours and be safe. So they get into the street, they start heading, and suddenly they listen and they say, what is that? That's bombing. I thought it's safe to flee. They're having to rush back in their house. What's going on? Russian forces are violating the evacuation corridor agreement at the time of this broadcast, made at just before 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time on a Saturday morning. Two evacuation corridors, part of the agreement of Ukraine and Russian officials featured on the channel the last week, have now been violated by Russian officials. The city of Mariupol is one of the cities where Russia is violating the agreement. Again, this is where women and children, they're not armed, they're trying to flee a war-torn country to go to Poland, trying to flee, are getting out of their house, running, and then having to run back in because they say, wait a second, there's bombing outside. The city of Mariupol says that citizens were going into the evacuation zone, running through the humanitarian corridor, and then suddenly being blocked by Russian troops. They also heard explosions. The Russian Defense Ministry also confirmed that this was happening. The city council of Mariupol, which is on social media actually, has been sending in telegram that the situation is out of control. Unfortunately, when we were already ready to evacuate, the regular army of the Russian Federation began shelling along the corridor. Imagine the visual. I'm not going to show it to you, but you can imagine with your thought process. Women and children told that there's a corridor, a few blocks, a few miles that they can run, a major highway or road to get to the Polish border for 5, 6, 7 hours, that they will be safe, they can get there, and they will find safety and freedom in Poland. And they get in that corridor and they start running with their belongings. Suddenly they see Russian troops blocking them and they hear shelling and they have to run back in. And they were told by that there was an agreement, this is what happened. This does not give a sense of security, says the city council in a statement obtained by LA just minutes ago. Negotiations are underway now. As soon as we get it, we will receive a security guarantee. We'll give another information. I'll feature more about this tonight on that evening's 1 hour broadcast. That's why you want to watch the show. Why? The good news is that Russian and Ukraine officials have scheduled, shortly after the time of this broadcast, a sit-down meeting to solve the situation. So there will be another meeting today between Russia and Ukraine officials Saturday morning to figure out why these residential areas cannot have safe corridors for women and children to flee. Meantime, President Zelensky has urged for a NATO no-fly zone of Ukraine. That's not happening because that'll bring Russian troops, that'll bring United Force, U.S. forces into the battle. And the situation is unfolding by the minute. Meantime, coming up today, brand new afternoons LA at 3 o'clock, brand new evenings LA at 5 o'clock. It's our 1 hour special report. And then don't miss that 7 o'clock edition of I Stand Ukraine, which also airs at 11 a.m. Situation unfolding by the minute. Where are we with your money today? We got a new $80,000 of stimulus check rounds featured in the membership newsletter upgraded last night. If you're a member last night, it went out 5 p.m. via the YouTube alert system and the LA alert system. The program's not live, but about to go live, and you want to pounce. This is what we're best at, folks. You're not going to see this in the local paper. You're not going to see it in broadcast media. It's $80,000 of checks, $15,000 to $80,000. You generally will qualify for it. Go get it. Then we have CR for Stimulus 3.1. 2.0, SS300, and Build Back Better Act. We have SS300 and grain and wheat and also the gasoline issue. Meantime, we have a lot of other breaking developing details, which I'll feature tonight on Evenings LA. That's a big show, and I appreciate all your comments. Finally, personal comment. It's in times like this that we as a family have to come together, and I'm really appreciative of how everyone has come together so strong and so heartfelt. If you have comments or questions or success stories for renting assistance or any suggestions of what you want to add, send me a private message on social media. Meantime, thank you for the people who have sent me these wonderful, kind messages overnight saying I'm loving the new Evenings LA show. The breadth of reporting, the depth of the analysis, and the accuracy of the financial news that impacts your wallet at home and internationally is getting a lot of great praises from viewers, and I appreciate your comments as well. A lot of time goes into those broadcasts, and it's important because you need to know how your money is impacted. When we talk about oil and gas, it may be very simple to understand oil and gas, but when we talk about things like wheat, and you go to Walmart or you go to your local store and you say, wait a second, why has bread gone up so much? And you don't think you know why it is. It's situations like Vladimir Putin's acts of aggression that show us that these industries are a little bit more complicated than we thought. And in times like this, we need a lot of information, and information especially in view of those acts of aggression. I'll see you next on I Stand With Ukraine Home Edition coming up at 11 a.m. Stay informed, stay focused, have a beautiful morning. Stay focused, the toast is toast and the butter is butter, and hopefully the toast won't go up too much by noontime. Oh boy, it's out of control, isn't that, bread prices? Stay informed, stay focused, have a beautiful day, and stay with Ally for more.